Welcome, guys. Kamikaze Kid here. We're back playing Firewatch, episode 2. In our last episode, pretty much we became a Mountie, or whatever you call these people, Firewatchers in Canada, but we're in Colombia or Colorado or something, mountains. And we are this guy called Henry, and basically we are alone, and it's like his story unraveling, basically. A few days ago, someone smashed this window. And we don't know who, but if you watched the last episode, it was two girls down at they were like skinny dipping, and we kind of pissed them off. We thought it might have been them, but we're going to continue this anyway and do a few more days of it and see how we go. So open the door. Can we grab them in our bag? Don't even know where we're going. I guess we just continue as this evening is and see what's next. Oh, okay. So M sets up our mission. So survey communications line north of the canyon. That's what our mission was. Jesus Christ. So north. I have to go this way. And R is run when I'm not holding this. So we're just heading this way to the communication lines. But we were pretty much talking to Delilah about Julie. I kind of revealed that Julie was, like, you know, our wife, and she just seemed like concerned about us, and it almost seems like she was like trying to flirt or was somewhat disappointed in it. Drop down here, Jesus. I wonder if each mission is just in a different direction of the canyon, because like to save us from, you know, seeing the same map or the same areas. So I don't know how big this map actually is. North. This way. Just dropping down all these big drops. Keep our light on for more guidedness. That's not even needed. It's not nighttime. I wonder if we can break our legs jumping down big jumps. Henry's a machine. Just taking it like a man. So, survey communication lines north of the canyon. North. I think it's just all straight down. It's like all downhill. I mean, look at this view. This is some view, like. Run. I'm actually wondering, like, what happens when we do this. Because there is some, like, the realistic nature of this is scary. Like, if in real life, if I had to do that, that'd be somewhat terrifying. You know. Do we just walk away all the way down? And I wonder what the communication lines is like. Like, are they broken or something? Like, what's actually wrong with them? I forget. And what other messed up shit's gonna happen to us as we like kind of pursue further into this? Is this where the communication lines are? It says north is this way. This almost seems like we're not going north. Like we're going into a cave. But perhaps it will lead us out to the right. We can only find out. Cave closed.
This cave is gated off.
It's to stop spelunkers from dying without getting the keys from the Forest Service office first.
Makes sense.
Although Debbie says she lost them like 3 years ago, so... Maybe its mysteries are locked away for good.
Ah, damn.
Yeah, but maybe you can find another one to get your caving kicks in.
Oh, this one's so close to home and convenient, though.
Aw, sorry, Hank.
Alright, so straight ahead. Yeah, it's a weird way, like, all these caves have these locked doors, and I'm wondering, like, is there secrets to this game that's not known? Like, I mean, like, what is in there, like? And all these interactions are very unique, I have to say. Like, I mean, like, you know, like, clearing bushes and... I know they seem stupid, but you don't really see that in games anymore, like, where they have additional kind of, like, openings, you know? I mean, like, normally most games are just, like, pushed through the bushes, like, by default controls. This has, like, animations for stuff like that, for jumping, climbing down and all. And, it, you know, it all correlates to, like, the realism of it. of like how hard it actually is in real life to get by these things. It really kind of adds to like being in the game, like, you know, feeling that. Okay, north is somewhere. Actually, these are the communication lines here, I think. Should we like report on them? Or can we even report on them? Is running up this hill too much for this guy? Because it's like...
I can see the wire you're talking about. It looks like it's in good shape from here.
We'll follow it up to the top of the trail if you can. You can head back as soon as you give me the all clear.
Got it.
Right, so she wants us to go to the end of the pipe wire line, or the wire line, and see what's actually, if there is a break in it or not, because there seems to be a problem with it if we're going all the way out to it. What's this say? Beartooth Part, Thorafor Fire Lookout. So there is someone else's fire lookout around this area? Oh, and we can toggle run by just, you don't have to hold it, you just tap it. And I'm in like run mode. Sort of. Is that a break in the line there? We can actually see it from here. But she wants us to go all the way, so at least we can confirm that there is an issue with it. And I'm wondering if it's like, who fixes that? Like if they send someone out via helicopter to fix it? Because all this stuff is like, this is like a real life job. People actually do this for a living. And we get to play it in a video game, which is kind of cool. Saves us from, you know, the harsh reality of the dangers of it. More beer cans.
Guess what?
What is it?
There's a bunch of empty cans up here.
Same as before?
Yep.
These fucking kids.
Literally are.
Why do you think they'd be up here?
Hell if I know, but they better have stayed away from our communication stuff.
We're not gonna fight naked girls again, are we? We that lucky? That fortunate? Okay. Green mist. That knock us out. Yeah, I wonder like if they broke the wire. Because we can I could tell from back there the wire is broken. More beer cans. Go to hell.
Yeah, okay, the wire's down here.
Okay, good. Any sign of those girls? Did they mess with anything?
I'll look around.
So yeah, well, they definitely messed with something. There was beer cans. I can't seem to, like...
Hey, so the wire is definitely down out here. I just found it. Yeah, the thing is, it doesn't look like the wind. It looks like it was cut deliberately.
That go to hell sign suggests it. And they go to hell sign.
Do you realize this is how people die? I mean, what if something happened to one of my lookouts while this was going on? And God forbid there's an actual fire burning out of control.
What do you want to do?
I want you to go find them.
And then find the teens.
I haven't thought that far ahead. That's not true. Everything that comes to mind is...
I have to say, Delilah's pretty cool.
Oh, yeah?
Hey, I came out here for a breath of fresh air and some adventure. What do you got?
I think I want you to just find them and scare the hell out of them.
Yeah, I'd make a spooky ghost costume, but they stole my sheets.
I don't know.
They actually did.
Wait for them to wander off and wreck their camp. Something that would make a teenage girl run home to mommy and daddy.
I'll find it.
Wreck their camp.
I'm gonna need a raise.
I have to go the long way.
Hiking back towards your tower and just keep an eye out for anything that would lead you to them.
Well, they're big into Red Eagle.
Great. See if you can find the path they took down from there. Maybe
how do
they
I
looped back around towards the lake or something. I doubt
do...
they're where they were yesterday, but they obviously can't have gone far.
I'm stuck. Alright. My character is like jam-bagged. I can't jump, like. I'm stuck behind a rock, and there's this...
Well, I hopped down a drop, and now I can't climb back up.
Oh, there we go. She'll explain.
I can just keep hiking, but I figured I should let you know in case I get myself trapped out here.
Well, hopefully that doesn't happen before you find these assholes. I was thinking you should probably head back to where you saw them last.
These people definitely... you know, cut the wire. The only problem here is now I'm stuck, and like literally even the person in the video game said, oh, there's no way out. There is no way you will, I could just jump here. I see a perfect thing here that I could like do. But I'm stuck in all directions. Unless this is an alternative path. Oh, it is. There we go. All right, so we found an alternative path. So I guess what we're going to do is follow the beer trail, because I noticed there's a lot of beer cans around here. Back up that way. Oh, I see one there. And here. It's not like I have to keep reporting on the trail. I just follow it. And hopefully this will just lead me back down the mountain or whatever. The problem is when I have options, like am I going the wrong way if I don't see?
I've got an overgrown trail here.
Yeah, that'll happen.
So I'm screwed when it comes to getting past it?
Mm-hmm. Screwed until you clear yourself, yeah.
Great. Well, if I come across some tools, I'll add groundskeeping to my ever-increasing responsibilities.
Which are handy ones to have. Okay, so the way I see it now is this game is actually pushing me into a definite direction, which I like, because, you know, in games like this, where it's vague which direction you go, it's needed. So that's good. 2 miles to the south. You know, we just said we'd confiscate the illegal stuff that they had, because they were being, you know, doing illegal things. It's understandable. I mean, it could have been worse. Is that a backpack? This is dangerous. So I'm wondering, like, if they're gonna stop with the attacking me.
There's an abandoned pack out here.
And it's not one of the teens?
No, it looks like it was lost a long time ago.
Well, you could always pilfer it for supplies.
Ooh, camera. Have we taken photos of ourselves previously?
Flush with ropes now. That pack was full of them, in decent condition too.
That's lucky.
I mean, there's enough rope here that I could just leave them hooked up, I think. Oh, get this. This pack came with one of those cardboard single-use cameras.
With pictures left?
Yeah, he only used 3 or 4.
Neato.
I think I'll take a picture while I'm repelling.
Wait, who?
The bag had the name Brian Goodwin sewn into the top.
Brian Goodwin?
Wow.
Do you know him?
Yeah, I just haven't heard that name in a few years.
He was a lookout?
Yeah, kinda, I guess. He was stationed in Two Forks, your lookout, with his dad Ned 3 summers ago.
I wanted to ask him.
No. You know, I'm not a stickler for rules. They took off halfway through the summer.
Oh, there's the...
Why? Where did they go?
I don't know. I never really hit it off with old Ned, and one day they were just gone. Sucks. Anyway, So it goes. Have fun with that camera. Try not to snap anything that would scar a photo dome employee.
I don't know. I have a lot of hiking to do. Might get bored.
Well, I'm bored as rocks, so I'll keep you company while you find those girls, huh?
Taking silly photos. At least you have the loyalty to keep us company about this. But now I'm wondering who that guy is, and maybe we should have asked if he was an ex-lover. I guess I just wanted to know, like, what, if he was one of these people, because it would make sense to the story if you ever turned up. What does he have?
She's got Alzheimer's. Like, dementia.
Oh. How old was she?
Is she? She's alive. She's with her family in Melbourne, Australia. She's 43.
Fuck.
That's horrible.
Yeah.
What was it like when you guys found out?
Devastating. Especially for her. You can understand.
And for you.
Anyway, everything she worked for was taken away.
Doesn't want to say.
That was it. Yeah.
That's a horrible thing
to
get.
Such a downer.
Don't even. I'm happy to listen. And, you know, we'll try to have some fun this summer. I promise.
Sam and I'm here all summer.
From this burned section of forest, I have no idea where to go. Their trail is pretty cold at this point.
You're out by Mule Point. No one would camp out in a fireweed. Well, I want you to stay out there, as a favor to little old me.
My pleasure.
Okay, we know these young women are sloppy. They must have left some sort of trail.
That's true. I can't find it, but we'll try to find it. But yeah, back to the whole thing about Delilah and I forget the name of the girl that
I'm having a hell of a time getting this fucking flapjack off his ass and out to repair that wire.
Excuse me?
It's hard to commentate over her talking.
You know, like a loser, a chotch.
I really don't, but I do now.
Well, the next time you're at a bar and some banker steps on your foot, so he can order his crappy martini.
Julius, the name of our wife.
Hey, Flapjack. Why don't you wait your turn before I bounce your face off a dumpster?
It's beautiful.
I'm actually having fun talking to Delilah. Maybe this will lead to something. But I am actually afraid because, like, you know, we have a wife and this is a very horrible scenario, the whole Alzheimer's thing. That's what I was saying. Julia, like, you know, I'm pretty sure Henry still loves her. He's just so concerned about the whole thing. I mean, his approach to with Delilah is that he's just happy having someone else, a friend, maybe. Like, he was so obsessed with looking after Julia that he hadn't time, you know, to make friends. So, you know, Delilah Ivan is just a friend. Why does it always have to be sexual or lead to something? Do you know what I mean? Like, he has someone there that could be a good friend in a scenario where it's needed. Like, I mean, if the dementia is true, does Julie even remember
hey, I found remember a structure us? That might have been an outhouse once, I think.
Whoa, you don't need my permission to go to the bathroom, but, you know, use abandoned shitters at your own peril.
Abandoned shitters? All these supply crates, I'm just wondering what's in there. Like, I could get guns and shit and, like, weed whackers. This looks fucking frightening.
Anything I should know about the cabin at the top of this hill? Hello?
Okay, ooh! Jeez, she doesn't want to talk to us. This is scary. Let's take a photo of it. This is one for the highlight reel. How do you take them? Click. There we go. That's scary. Look at that view you get from here. It's brilliant. This view is like unreal. Okay. Whoa. That's frightening. Destroyed guitar. Yeah, like, just to fucking throw it on the ground. Put it back. Comment. Maybe there's no reception down here. But the reason I'm, like, kind of intrigued about this is because it's so fucking scary. In real life, I wouldn't go here, but, you know, from now I can. Old stove. How scary is that? Oh, if there's someone standing here, I just turned off the screen. Old trash. Shit outside window. Flashy lights. Flashy lights. Right, so there's an old cabin and there's nothing in it. Typical. And there's no reception there. I wonder if he'll talk about it now based on that. Okay, I don't know where we're going. Like, I think we hit a dead end with the cabin. Obviously, I can't do anything about it. Just go back. All this here would suggest, like, you know, someone was living here, but it's abandoned, and therefore, they're not living here.
2 hours later.
Never seen that smoke. That's exactly where we have to go, to that smoke.
I see a really thin plume of smoke.
Yeah, I see it too. A thin plume like this is either a new fire or a campfire.
Campfire? You think it's them?
I reckon so.
It looks like it's to the southwest of me.
That's right. If you hike towards Five Mile Creek, that should put you in the neighborhood. Keep an eye on that smoke plume. Let me know if it's getting any larger.
It's rolling down this mountain. Well, all this running around, you'd really be fit from it. Right, so we have to literally go straight. I think through this open gate that looks like somebody cut it off.
Hey, Delilah?
What do you got? You found him?
No, not yet. Why would there be a fence out here?
Because sometimes hikers go ass over tea kettle when on a trail.
So the Forest Service would put up a big chain link fence?
A chain link fence?
Yeah, it looks like it surrounds a huge area.
Huh, that's weird.
Who are they keeping out of here, and why?
Jeez, I don't know.
This is strange, actually.
Biologists, you know? Well, they don't want people traipsing on their precious lichens.
What's a lichen?
Wouldn't you lichen to know?
Oh my god, goodbye.
Play on words, Jesus Christ.
That'll probably be a few days.
Right, so I don't know what's in this fence. I'd assume that they got in by cutting the chainmail on it. Maybe they didn't cut it. Maybe that's just the way it's presented. We're too fat to climb over it, so we're going the long way.
Maybe I'll go visit. I don't know.
Well, why not?
Doesn't know.
She's with her family in Melbourne. They're not big fans of mine.
Oh.
Her sister, Susan, is great, but her parents, I think they always thought she could do better. And that I could have done a better job looking after her.
Fuck that. I have no doubt you did your best.
I don't know.
If you want to go visit her, you should go.
It's a shame, really.
Don't let a couple of assholes keep you away from someone you love.
I'll think about it.
The way he's saying it is, like, he's heard from her. Like obviously he loves her if he's been trying his best. And he's clearly been trying his best, but maybe it's just, like, that fear of the family or, you know, I mean, dementia itself. Like, you just, once you have it, like, it's really hard to feel the same about somebody after the way it's gone. I don't know myself. But, I have a feeling that it's definitely something that would change someone's opinion of someone. I mean, if you know someone with dementia and, like, especially if they don't even remember you or if they're just continuously, like, just hard to deal with, trying to get them to do things and they can't remember it, it is very different.
I'm on top of a natural bridge out here.
Really? Is it a complete arch?
No, I guess the bridge is out here. Still, I think I could jump this gap to get across the canyon.
Wow, you're a regular Evel Knievel.
Oh yeah, you should see the jumpsuit I'm wearing.
Should we do the jump? Jesus. Did it. Instead of going down and around underneath. I reckon we climb up, because it's just... I don't know, maybe we'll get like a height advantage. I hope. Kill music starting. Right, gonna run up and around. I mean, we don't have to use all our ropes. As many as he made out that there would be. Right, gonna run around this way and to the right. Or, you know, get fucking stopped by rocks. The music and the scenery is, like, actually pretty cool, isn't it? It's like a film almost of what's going on. I think we're back to, like, an area we were at. Oh, like, his actual senses highlight. So the thing called him Smoke is here. Ah, he's seen it before I did. That's how good this Henry guy is at his job. He can spot things before we see them. There's not much I can report at the moment. I do find out, like, this is a harder game to commentate than most games. I mean, the amount of talking that the characters do in it, it happens, like, when you least expect it. So it's really hard to time, like, you know, what I want to say, like. So I try to stop and let them talk and listen myself, you know, really. Alright, so we're very close now. You can probably see what's going on before. No, we thought we were close. Still miles away.
I'm back at the shale slide. You know, the one that nearly killed me yesterday.
You ready to give it another shot?
Do I seriously have to?
To get down to Five Mile Creek? Yeah, afraid so. It's quite a ways downhill from here.
This must be really hard to do. I can't see what's so difficult about it. You hold onto a rope and you go backwards down a mountain. Is it because we're heavy? Like we're really fat? Or what's the story? I'm not even fat, we're just built. Is it because we did it? Alright, doesn't matter. Should we report success? Surprised you didn't. For me, it'd be reporting success. Do we go down again? A little change. Okay. Down we go. It's a weird mist there. Wonder if it's just from, like, us. Okay, are we nearer to this thing now? Is it just around the corner? Because you have to remember, where as the smoke rises, it doesn't mean it's in the sky. It could be down here for all we know. So as we get nearer, it's like the time changes. It's actually cool the way that, like, the day progresses as we play. So scary though. Did they map the mark? Oh, there, 5% there, bottom. So you have to go. Yeah, we're going this way. We have to go slightly that way. Okay. Oh, we can even zoom and stuff. Woo. You know all this stuff I didn't even know about.
Boy, for as dry as it is this summer, there's an area down here that's lush.
Oh, you must be talking about the Aspen Grove down there.
Yeah, lush?
I think that's where I am.
Those trees are actually one root organism. Did you know that?
I didn't.
Do
yeah,
you swim?
Share their water is a colony that can live for hundreds of years, even through fire.
Just go swimming? I'm gonna follow the river.
To learn all of these amazing things. Also, by what it looks like on this map, you'll be coming up on a stream that should lead you towards where we saw that smoke.
Grand. So, I guess the advantage of, whatever way they made this game is that we can follow the stream.
Found one of their empties. Guess we're on the right track.
Roger that.
It's a really nice waterfall down here. Given those girls love a skinny dipping, I bet they're nearby.
I love the reference. So, did we go through? Oh, I'm still holding the poxy compass. I mean, if it makes any sense, it would mean that we've successfully followed the waterfall behind. Or did I just go the wrong way?
Whoa, their tent is demolished.
You're there? Where are they?
I don't know. Gone. This whole place is torn apart.
What happened?
Okay, we found.
Honestly, it looks like it could have been a bear.
Oh, Jesus.
Okay, I need to be honest with you. If I find a dead body out here, I'm going to be sick.
Don't yak. Just look around and let me know what you find. Actually, you've got that camera, right? It might be a good idea to get a few snaps, just in case.
Yeah, good thinking.
Imagine. Oh, there's a note.
Oh, they're gone, for sure.
How can you tell?
Well, the girls left someone, me, I guess, a note.
Well, what's it say?
Threatening to call the police because they think I attacked them.
Oh my god, well, did you?
No, well, hey, I didn't do this. Okay, someone or Something went to town here, but it wasn't me.
Because I told you to scare them, not assault them.
Yeah, I took their whiskey.
She doesn't believe me. This is strange.
That's different, okay? And I don't blame you.
This is, I don't know, weird as hell, but it wasn't me.
It's okay. I believe you. Weird stuff happens in the woods. It could be other campers. They could be having a bad mushroom trip. We really don't know.
Bad mushroom trip.
Gone. There's no way to call the cops. They're not coming back.
Fucking trees.
And we can get to work. I'd really like to start enjoying a quiet summer.
Yeah, me too.
Oh. We skip ahead to day three. Didn't get to read the note properly, but maybe you can pause the video and check what was actually said in it. But yeah, Jesus Christ, like, they're threatening to call the police on us. So that means the police is going to come out here into the wilderness and arrest us. And now we're fixing up our barred windows and shit. My board's downstairs to patch the window. Starting again. Where is she?
Well, I get confused for Burt Reynolds all the time.
So that's our terror.
Oh, is that so?
She has a terror near her.
Similar musk.
I'd say it's this one.
Hey, you asked.
Ah, Dullalister.
Okay, well, that gives me a good start. Now let's see. In my scope, I can only tell you're a white guy wearing shorts.
It's hot. And maybe, by the way, I'm not white.
Jesus.
Very, you know, PC or whatever they say.
Oh my god, you are the whitest man. Wow. I don't need a spotting scope for that. And if not shorts, then...
She's so mean.
Like to wear.
Clothes. I don't really think about it.
Come on.
Jesus Christ.
A sweatshirt I like. Good jacket I got at the Buckle Barn.
Buckle Barn.
Just one of those brown ones, you know.
I do. Now tell me about your face. I'm looking at you across the bar. What do I see?
Thought about my beard?
Pretty thick beard.
Oh, have you always had a beard?
For a while, yeah.
All right, perfect. I want to know about your eyes.
Is she drawing me or something?
I'll
take a picture of her tower.
Is that okay? Don't answer. I'm gonna do it regardless.
Fine.
Your eyes, tell me.
Steely.
They're steely. Cold, hard stare.
A real blue steel.
Like Siberian husky.
Oh, Jesus.
Okay, got it. Thank
hitting
you.
Fucking the mic all over the gaff.
Get what you need?
Absolutely.
Wish everything was just... You know, in place. Okay, she has everything. I think she's done talking to us. As I was saying before, I was rudely interrupted by Delilah for the 800th time. Because it's really hard to commentate over this game. I'm not going to bloody lie. Obviously, we're going to repair this window. The girls have left, supposedly. I doubt it. You never know, though. Maybe they'll be back to destroy our bleeding house again or whatever. They've caused enough problems for us. Or rather, someone has caused problems for them because it seems like a bear or something attacked their shit. Delilah clearly, like, finds us attractive. She's willing to draw us. So she's, like, at least a good friend. Our wife at home. I know we've learned that because obviously we only are finding out the information from Henry. As we ask certain questions or go certain routes, so he's revealed that the dementia is what the Julia has, and you know he doesn't really seem like he wants to continue that relationship with her, somewhat. So it's like, do we go for a love story with Delilah? What happens next? I don't know. Like so, then the next episode, obviously, we have to you know repair this window and see what the next mission is. Because if you top M, find boards downstairs to patch window. But then we have a full day of work ahead of us. And God knows what other tragic things will happen. Because this game is so, like, crazy like that. Yeah, and I'll get back to the same game pretty soon. And hopefully you will enjoy the next episode. As we see what happens. But anyways, thanks very much for watching, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video today. And if you did, you know what you have to do. Like, subscribe, join the Kamikaze tribe. And I'll see you guys at the next one.